Bad bitch with a tan. Do you know one by chance? 100 bags in the land. Do you have one by chance? Need to see this ant man. Do you know him by chance? A ziplock full of kush. Are you plugged in by chance? Bad bitch with a suntan. Do you know one by chance? 100 bags in the land. Do you have one by chance? Need to see this ant man. Do you know him by chance? A ziplock full of kush. Are you plugged in by chance?
Pick a price for me, please. We can spend whatever.
That was a really good manual YouTube.
That was, yeah. You should be an expert.
B minus.
You should DJ like bat mitzvahs and weddings. That's what you should do.
If you take acid at a bar mitzvah, it'll be a lot better.
Yeah. Well, I guess we should introduce everybody and probably this third random human being. So this is the most self-deprecating podcast on the internet. We pride ourselves in that. I'm Shad. This new human being is Ian, and he's not allowed to speak for himself yet because he hasn't earned it. And this guy over here is...
The third one.
Yeah, he's the
third one. They just took the tape off my mouth. Thank you. I'd like to thank Tony Blair. Yeah, Nigel.
Nigel Farage, that
Nigel
is.
Nigel Farage.
All right.
Did you guys see Chief Keef's new fashion statement?
What is
okay,
it?
Okay, so Chief Keef is wearing these, it's like a Under Armour shirt. It's Nike, and it's for football. It's for... It's like padded around your ribs, so if you were to get hit by a helmet in your ribs. And there's also, for some reason, extra padding on the shoulder, which I've never understood.
No, I saw that. I saw that on Instagram. It was hilarious.
Like, yeah, making a statement.
It's making his lean gut look a lot better, though. It's good for his physique.
Somehow.
Why?
What are your favorite... like top three post rap Chief Keef like career endeavors? I'm gonna say like maybe the like paintball, like sponsoring paintball teams. I heard he's getting into mini golf.
Mini golf? That's
sponsoring
a good one.
Competitive mini golf, bowling. I think he goes bowling. Gang. Yeah, you know when just
bowl
like,
gang.
You know when you're like bowl hungover. Bowl gang. Yeah, you know when you're like hungover on like Sunday or something, and you just like turn ESPN on. There ain't shit on. It's like bowling or like poker. Yeah, Chief Keef's just getting into like sports that like get in that like 11 a.m. on a Sunday like niche.
Okay. I'm into his drone activity. You guys follow his drone activity?
No, but he has buys the goggles and everything.
He buys expensive drones and flies them around his house and tries to record music videos. It's amazing.
Why not? Yeah. If you got the cash.
He's trying to direct videos? He's trying to direct his own videos?
I think so. He just stands at the corner of his pool with his gut out, holding the remote control, watching the drone go up.
He's rapping?
No, he's just playing. Oh, no, he should, though. Someone contact him and tell him to do that.
I just want a video of him. Who's the Dragon Ball Z character that has, like, the goggle Oakley glasses? The purple guy. The purple white thing?
I never watched that.
Yeah,
show.
Me neither. Nigel, you were the one that
watched that.
Okay, the
Siamese
guy
twin man. The guy has his tail cut off and then it grew back like a lizard.
Dragon Ball Z.
Lizard man. Purple guy.
Frieza.
Frieza. Yeah,
okay,
yeah,
so
yeah.
Frieza, yeah. He had these drone glasses before there were drone glasses. Did you ever see the drone glasses they used?
Yeah, no, yeah.
They
yeah.
look exactly the same.
It's like the Willy Wonka glasses.
Yeah, that stuff is crazy that they put that on ESPN, and it really just is the future of killing. And they're like, look at these future murderers dude. That we're like putting.
No,
isn't droning
realize,
so
like,
cool?
Stadiums and sports stadiums are putting a lot of money into like drone defense. They're putting like massive fans at the top of the stadiums to blow the drones away.
Have you ever seen another one of these white people favorites is Frisbee golf?
No, yeah, frisbee golf's a big thing.
Oh, wow, frisbee golf is ridiculous.
Yeah, it's really big in Dayton.
I saw a couple of idiots walking around today in the park, and they had just clearly a cooler full of beer that they were pretending to have frisbees in. That was, like, the joke. And then they were just literally standing on one side of the road just throwing these frisbees into the tree. I don't know if there was a hole over there. I don't know what the deal was, but
yeah,
they were just launching.
Sport is really just an elaborate joke to like do drugs.
To smoke weed in the woods.
It's
yeah,
very,
yeah.
No,
like,
it's just
I don't want to go on a hood. I don't want to go on a hike, but
it's really just an excuse to do something on a Sunday. It's like
why would
they're
you do
hungover,
that?
They think it's exercise.
Why would
and
you
they just
that?
Run around and throw a frisbee. And then sometimes you maybe like trot to go get your terrible throw in the woods.
Little trot.
Yeah, a little trot.
A little trotty. I don't know.
An inch off the ground.
Who are these people that have energy and stamina to do things on Sundays? So like, I'm gonna go and like get out of bed and do something. Like,
I mean,
nah.
No, there's just an inherent depression that comes with Sunday. And
yeah,
I don't
exactly.
People who don't like feel that, like,
They don't have real responsibilities.
That's what I'm
saying.
That's why you just
that's
like
what keeps you inside.
Stay inside.
That's what keeps you honest. That's what that
keeps
what
the crippling anxiety inside me.
Yeah,
that's what lets you know the fucking the work week is messed up.
Just live in a constant state of dread and fear.
Yes.
Yeah, that makes for a good society. That's how you keep people in order and in line. All right, are we watching this?
Do we want to watch Chinaman?
Are we watching this egregious racism?
Fox News went to Chinatown.
All right, I'm gonna literally hold this in my lap.
And okay.
Hope this works.
Shad is holding R2-D2 right now.
He's holding a torso-sized speaker.
It's a Marshall half person. Stack, is what I'm holding.
Okay. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Brought to you by Polo.
Play it. I'm gonna hold it, but play it.
All right. Do you need assistance? I can come on the side of you.
I don't need any help, brother. I can hold it myself.
All right.
You can play it.
Play it. We're gonna have to pause it a lot.
Oh.
Oh.
All right. In the first presidential debate, China. Fuck it. We'll do it live.
Was mentioned 12 times. Look at the smile. Look at the smile. Just staring into the abyss right now.
The reporter has his collar popped.
Oh, no.
He has his collar popped in the profile photo before the
It looks like
begins.
He's standing in the Mojave Desert
oh,
right now.
Oh, my God.
Down to New York's Chinatown to sample political opinion.
Do you think Bill O'Reilly was put into this?
I hear he's secretly Democrat.
Am I supposed to bow to say hello?
May ho.
I like these watches. Are they hot?
JC Penney, 398.
Ooh! Do you like?
All right, Mr. so they're cutting in BuzzFeed gifts every like 30 seconds that are just like pretty racist
yeah.
in nature.
No, it's pretty bad. Yeah.
Donald Trump. Yes. Hillary Clinton. Basically, it's the extension of Obama.
Who are you going to vote for?
Clinton wife.
Clinton's wife has a name. What is it?
Oh, man. Don't forget it.
Snap out of it.
What do you...
Oh, it's so bad.
Trump.
I don't like it. He has a big mouth.
He can say what he wants. It doesn't really affect me. And I don't think he's going to win, so...
Trump has been beating up on China. How does that make...
Okay, this is the worst.
That kid
one.
Is on 4chan. That kid is on 4chan. He's like, I don't give a shit. I'm just gonna keep like what scamming people on the internet for money. So he thinks he's gonna protect the cyber. I'm cool with it.
What are his favorite boards? What is his favorite?
What
boards?
Does he browse? That's a good question.
Yeah, we gotta figure that out.
Probably the weapons one.
The weapon K.
K. Weapon
K. Okay.
Speak. Why don't you?
Okay, so. Yeah, this is a pretty, like, visual-heavy thing, so, like, a lot of it, I guess, is missed when you're holding a microphone to a speaker, but, yeah, they just, like, asked, like, an elderly woman a question, and then just, like, made fun of the fact that she didn't understand the question, or, like,
she didn't understand English?
She doesn't
understand the question.
English, like, it was...
Yeah, okay,
it's
that's
pretty bad.
Offensive.
It's very...
But that's how this works.
And then they just like cut out and go to the next person like nothing happens.
Yeah, they don't. They're oh. treating them like props. There's
they don't
no
let
like...
any of this soak in for anyone that's well, watching that's, this live on the news.
Is it
there's the crickets.
The Rabbit. Who are you going to vote for?
I really don't want to vote for Trump, so Hillary.
So China can keep ripping us off.
I guess.
Oh.
Trump wants to build a wall to keep the Mexicans out.
Mm-hmm.
Square that circle.
I like Donald Trump. Before I was a Deborah.
Jackpot. Is everything made in China now?
Not everything.
Tell me what's not made in China.
I can't think of it right now.
Me neither.
I'm explaining to you because you look nervous.
Is China America's friend or enemy?
China, America? Of course, our friends.
Can you guys take care of North Korea for us?
Wow, that is too much.
Yeah,
too much.
I guess
too much.
Frenemies?
Frenemies? Do they call Chinese food in China just food? Do you have any traditional Chinese herbs for performance?
I'm not gonna ask my parents about that.
I meant on television.
Oh, okay, okay.
Was there a seat in that?
They're not allowed to use Larry David.
Yeah, I'm surprised he hasn't sued already. I'm sure he would object.
Yeah, Fox News is not.
The three interns that made this are already gone.
Yeah, that's the issue. These BuzzFeed gifs.
Yeah, they just watched Eric Andre
and took it
to the alt-right and thought they could just zoom in on people that don't speak English. And just throw a BuzzFeed gif. Is this what's happening
in the post-Roger Ailes era? They're just letting 23-year-olds run amok in the production room?
You could see it on the Fox
Fox has been taken over. These libs have taken it over.
Ah. Sweep the legs.
Do you know karate?
Yeah, I know.
Hit my hand. That's nothing.
Okay.
Yeah, they also shouldn't be using Napoleon Dynamite clips. And yeah, exactly. Who in the audience of the O'Reilly Factor would understand the reference of the dude, the karate instructor from Napoleon Dynamite? Who are these weird interns just like doing this for fun?
Yeah, they just
contract the editing out
to BuzzFeed people. They're just like, just edit these clips together for us and smash send them back.
Smash them up. Roger's gone. Just smash them up.
Why is he just making these noises?
So it's racist.
It's like a Tekken noise.
Do you guys like to party?
What is that Chris Farley movie that is used the clip from?
Ninja something, Ninja Monkey.
A white Ninja.
Yeah. Poppy Chula. Like him and David Spade.
I don't know if it's a white ninja.
No, I'm just saying.
That's so funny.
White Ninja. Yeah.
Beverly Hills Ninja.
Yeah. Oh.
No, that's Beverly Hills Cop.
Whoa.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Keep going.
Oh, God, I'm going to get sick.
Oh, God.
How do they dance in China? I'm sick. Can you play This Little Piggy Went to Market? How do I say in Chinese, this is my world?
You gotta say it right. You don't say it. Nico. Not Japanese, Chinese.
Yeah, he's right. You don't just go around making fun of people's language. Yeah, don't say it unless you're really like planning to like. It's fucked up, man.
You gotta do it properly.
Okay, teach me.
Otherwise, forget it.
Nigo hai
go
go
get sai guy.
And the fact that he's making him tell him to say this is my world. Saying to that man that this isn't yours, this is mine.
Hated you.
He did.
Yeah, he did.
Okay. That's enough.
Yeah, this popped collar, this popped collar reporter is really just insufferable. Yeah, I don't know what you do about that. I don't know when. I mean, when the communist revolution comes, those people will be purged. I mean,
who is this fake ass like Aaron or Steven Crowder ass motherfucker they have out here?
Who's Steven Crowder?
Yeah, who is that?
Steven Crowder's the Canadian. He's gigantic. He's on like the Gavin McGinnis tip.
Oh, he's like an all right dude.
Yeah, and he's out here. He's like, Hillary, like, you're Canadian. You can't vote here. Like, keep your bullshit politics out of my life.
I haven't seen that anywhere. So I think they figured out the day of the week and the exact time to be posting these things where it doesn't hit the news at all.
Is it this guy?
Yeah, he is.
Oh, that guy's gross.
We're not going to watch it, but. If you humans know, I cannot handle carrying the speaker on my shoulder anymore. So
yeah, it looks pretty heavy.
I'm done with it.
Yeah.
Old boy took a beating.
Who?
Holding that speaker.
You.
Oh, yeah. You. Well, I'm back in action. I'm back at it. Stop. What about, I saw that there was a clip, apparently, of Donald Trump saying the N-word, and there. They were holding it, you know, like, it's out there, though. We're going to put it out there.
They're just waiting. They're waiting.
And the comment was like, it's over. It is over. Like, you think that the people who are voting for him care about that? Like, what? Who are you talking to? Who is this audience that is listening?
You think he's going to lose 65-35?
It's going to be
That's still impressive. If he, there's video of him saying the N-word and saying whatever he said on some, like, fucking wild shit.
But all these videos really mean nothing to these voters, like you said. Yeah, it doesn't matter.
They don't care. They're like, well, hell yeah.
Yeah. Like, and there's no such thing.
If I was Donald Trump, I'd grab girls by the pussy too. I think anybody out there understands that.
Ugh. But no, there's no undecided voters. And if there are, it's very, very, very small. And what point, what inflection point is going to hit where they see a video and be like, oh, voting for the other one? It's not going to happen. They're just not going to vote.
I know them.
Boy, good thing you convinced me the election was only 3 days away. I would have voted for the other guy. Jeez.
Hey, shit gets real when you get in that booth and nobody else is around.
I think we should just go back to the days when, like, when there were just, like, political machines that would just intimidate voters, just have, like, knee breakers at the polls who just ask you who you voted for. Or they go in with you. They go in behind the curtain with you and watch who and what you fill out.
The Andrew Jackson glow game.
Make things a lot more make things much simpler.
Well, they kind of do that, don't they?
How?
No, you're not allowed within, like, what is it, some arbitrary feat?
Don't all districts just contract out the local Hell's Angels precinct?
Well, like, there, what, was it 2012 when the quote-unquote new Black Panther parties in some isolated town put, two, like, minorly psychotic men, like, on the steps to the building and, like, Fox News erupted with, like, the Black Panthers are back and they're intimidating voters.
Where was this?
What did they do? Stand
it
on the...
It was some, like, bum-fuck town, like, bum-fuck nowhere.
Ugh. They just stand there with their arms closed?
Yeah, they
pools
were just,
closed.
Like, they,
pools
yeah,
closed.
Were on some, like,
pools closed for the day.
Type.
It's adult swim.
Pools closed.
Can't come in, children.
What if they totally mistook them as Black Panthers and they were just dudes trolling?
Yeah, the Habbo Hotel troll kids grew up to be the alt-right. That's what happened.
I think that's
the alt-right. Yeah, I think this podcast is quickly becoming the number one place for alt-right news.
Number one red pill on the internet.
Alt-right watch.
Yeah, I've been checking the analytics on your guys' previous podcasts, and it's been great. Hey. Yeah, the numbers are skyrocketing.
Yeah.
Projected way
past
me.
The alt-right numbers.
The alt-right numbers.
Yeah.
The alt-right demo.
The big data. Big data.
Big data. Machine learning.
Machine learning. SaaS programming.
Woo. What are the buzzwords you got for blockchain?
Blockchain.
Ooh, I love the blockchain,
C++.
Dude.
Internet 3.0.
Ooh, 3.0, but what's 4.0?
Blockchain.
Ooh, blockchain.
Blockchain.
Ooh. Digital currency.
Internet of Things.
Dogecoin.
E-Corp.
Evil Corp.
Is Mr. Robot good, dude? Is television good?
Oh, Mr. Robot's
bad.
I think Mr. Robot's good. It's a solid show.
It's solid, but
solid
is all the TV, is any of the TV good?
I selectively handpick and curate my TV experiences.
But
is
any of it good, like, philosophically, like, is any of it good?
Ever? No.
Any of the prestige television?
Prestige television where it's just, like, lengthy shows with no real,
like,
story plot.
Yeah. Just this shit.
You just think it's good because it's longer.
And it's like,
people get excited when Game of Thrones is longer than an hour.
Like, oh, it's an hour and 12 minutes this time. That 12 minutes is really... Whoo.
Can't wait for
it's
that one.
It's almost like a movie.
Yeah. No, it was bad.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, what's Ned Stark going to do this week? What's Ned Stark going to do? I heard Ned Stark's ghost is coming back next season.
Really?
He's about to...
I don't
FSU.
Like the shows. They keep bringing
people
back to
life. Is that Tony Stark's brother?
It's Tony Hawk's brother, dude.
Tony Hawk, yeah.
Dude, Tony Hawk's my dad.
Bob Burnquist is going to be in the new season.
Bob Burnquist, dude. Who was your favorite skater on, like, Tony Hawk's Pro Skater?
Kareem Campbell.
Pro Skater too, because he's the only Black dude.
Yes.
But he was, like, street skater. I always liked the, like, vert dudes.
You like the vert guys?
Ride, like, Bob Burnquist is, like, best of both worlds.
I hated
and he had the
vert.
Cool name. Like, Burnquist just sounds, like, appropriate for, like... Bucky Lasik had, like, the cool, like, name that seems, like, indicative of, like...
Yeah. No, I went Rodney Mulley a lot.
Rodney Mullins?
Y'all are I don't tripping. Know his name.
Y'all are all tripping.
Who?
Cheat codes,
whom?
Man.
Cheat codes?
Darth Maul.
Darth Maul,
the Silver
bro.
Surfer?
Yeah, Darth Maul was always the best. Whichever Tony Hawk that was.
I didn't like those. Then you had to, like, learn a 5-button combination to do the lightsaber thing.
No, what you would
not
do...
Good.
Oh, it was great. And then what you would do is go find a pool, and you
infinite.
Would just turn the infinite grind on, and you would just leave it there, and you'd go, like, play football or
I
play
did that
another
one time.
Video game or some
I
shit.
I did that one time. I just turned the TV on, so you had to plug it in, you know, AV.
Yeah,
I just unplugged the video input. And watched it go for 2 hours, and I got the highest score.
That's so
like,
funny.
Very gratifying.
With HDMI, it wouldn't work.
What were your favorite?
That's so funny.
What were your favorite, like, derivative games of Tony Hawk, but either, like, different extreme sports or different, like, or, like, they had the Matt Hoffman, like, Then there was like Dave Mira, RIP.
The Slim Jim bike game.
But then there was like aggressive inline skating. And then there was like
the Triple X.
The Razor X. Oh, there was a Razor scooter.
The Razor game was stupid. That was so good. Oh, my goodness.
You just said it was stupid.
Yeah, in a positive manner.
It was dumb,
I don't
mean son.
That. Yeah, like
it was mad stupid.
Mad stupid.
We need
the game was mad stupid.
We need to tell the audience what it actually is.
It's phenomenal, I guess. If you want me to be literal,
it's a great game. It's a great time.
Yeah, great time.
Superb. 10 out of 10. Great time.
I hurt my knee really bad on a Razor scooter, so I think that snake bit my mentality towards everything.
Lost the top of my fucking tooth to a Razor scooter. Tatted on my goddamn arm.
Really.
Yeah, the wheelie bar was better.
People tried to bring scooters back on campus like a year ago. Like right before the right before the what's the ones that blow up with the battery?
The Segway. No, the
not Segway.
Hoverboards.
Yeah. Right before hoverboards became a thing, I started noticing this trend of people trying to bring back scooters to like go to class.
No, that was big my freshman sophomore year. I saw it a lot. People were like, oh, there's so many hills in Cincinnati.
It's childish.
Can you imagine someone leaning?
Stop trying to bring your childhood back. Grow up. Be an adult. Get a car.
No, you would just see them folded up and carry them into a building.
Somebody doing like
come up and just hit them.
Just 160 degrees, like towards the hill, just like. Murr.
Oh,
that'd be hilarious.
No, I really got into SSX Tricky. You guys ever play that?
You're the only person who ever played SSX.
Boy,
shit. I bought it.
And then there was SSX on Tour, which was another one they had for GameCube, and it was really good. You could play as like Luigi and Mario.
I never got that.
Oh, the graphics were so much better. It was a great game. Honestly, if you got a GameCube laying around, just fucking cop that shit.
Get an emulator, dude.
Yeah, well.
Yeah, GameCube emulators work now?
I don't know. I've never even tried.
Do like PS2?
If anybody out there has any fucking knowledge on that.
No, they have to work by now because they were like starting to work when we were like kids.
If you're not playing emulators, you're missing out, really.
I wish I had time to just sit around and play RPGs.
What was that?
When I may or may not have been enjoying myself on substances that might make you hallucinate, allegedly. I was playing a lot of emulators, and the best part about emulators is they take up absolutely no space, and you can get games, and they're like 64 kilobytes for like game, not GameCube, but N64 rather. Good time. You can just play tons of games, just download them instantly.
I don't know if I have that much space
ROMs,
on my computer.
Bro. Well, get a hard drive. Be an adult, Ian.
Get terabyte, bro.
I need a terabyte. I need the Triceratops.
Well, don't do what I did and get a terabyte drive with no power.
Yeah, how much was that?
I'm not going to discuss prices here.
I almost got you.
It's a piece of shit, though. I can tell you that. Don't buy this anything that doesn't have an external power cord. That's my tech tip of the week, is do not buy any external hard drive that doesn't have its own power. Y'all, why did you do this?
I don't want to watch SSX. Currently, we're watching SSX Tricky.
Nigel fucked around and put SSX Tricky in.
And then he's just
and
catching
us. Trance.
Yeah, we're just watching.
The game is art, dude. The game is
beautiful.
It was
good, but I don't want to watch it.
It's a beautiful aesthetic. Okay, calm down.
You went to a...
went to a place.
Ugh.
I guess we have to kind of discuss Donald Trump's.
Dude, you don't have to talk anything about that man.
No,
I mean it's a good topic. It's interesting.
Is it?
I'd rather.
Is Donald Trump actually like?
No.
Is it actually?
He should release a mixtape.
Is it
That's what's
interesting.
Interesting.
No, everyone's just
there are
bored.
Funny jokes to be made.
Everyone's just bored and wants to talk about this.
Yeah.
This crimply man.
This large man.
This large man, pasty man.
You know, I just go around and I grab pussies. You know.
Yeah, he record. What is that like? 2005 in a bus.
Yeah,
going to a TV show.
That man's a narc.
Man.
Whoever held on to this
narcoleptic.
That's probably the most interesting thing about it to me is how much did this man want from Donald Trump that Donald Trump told him to go kick rocks?
He's no, like, I think he.
He's
yeah,
just to the
no,
point,
I don't. I don't. Yeah,
he's
well,
just
I don't
to the point where he wanted
money,
to like
yeah.
hurt his.
You don't think so?
Public
you don't
figure.
Think he tried to blackmail him, get money out of him?
No,
no, he was just like
he just did it.
That's even more bullshit. I would at least try to blackmail the man. What,
yeah, you could.
I mean, what are you doing out here?
You get like $100,000 out of that.
Yes, Hillary putting money in your. That's another. Do you go to Hillary and ask for some cash?
No, he definitely consulted with a couple people with large pockets to figure out
so
what
he
to
got
do
money.
With this tape.
He got money, presumably. Somehow
he
got money.
Well, I'd never heard of the guy.
No.
Billy,
well, I never heard
Billy
of him.
Bush.
Billy Burnham.
Is it Billy Bush?
Is Bo Burnham?
Yeah,
Bo Burnham leaked the tape of...
It was Bo Burnham.
Wow,
on
dude.
His new comedy special.
Wow, Bo Burnham really came back. No, dude, that's my conspiracy theory, dude. Hannibal Buress was literally just... Okay, yeah.
A plant.
Yeah, Hannibal Buress' entire career was a plant to just come out and make that comment about Bill Cosby, because you haven't seen him since.
Yeah.
I guess Eric Andre came back out, but that theory held up for like a couple months because he just like was not around after he just like dropped that.
No, he had
truth
a TV show
about,
and
he...
Yeah,
no, he had a terrible TV show, and I watched.
He's been around. He's been touring.
Bill Cosby's definitely
it,
a rapist, though.
I
he's definitely
exists.
Blind.
Bill Cosby,
he's
yeah,
definitely
he's blind.
Blind as a bat.
He's very blind.
Is that an excuse so for his behavior?
No, it's just a fact. Yeah, he's just blind as shit.
It's just sympathize. We're trying to sympathize with the rapist right now.
Are we?
Yeah.
Or are we just demonstrating God's power of retribution? Take a man's sight and his career in one stroke.
Take his hands.
One fell swoop.
I want to take his
Bomani
hands.
Was it Bomani Jones that said...
hands next.
Hands are next, yeah.
Bomani Jones, who blocks me on Twitter, by the way, he was saying that he had a friend that worked at like Best Buy or Circuit City and said that Stevie Wonder was in there hand-picking televisions.
He was just filling them up.
What? No.
Yeah, that's
no.
Hilarious. I want that one. I want the pictures bad on that one, but I like
Ooh.
That one.
Ooh.
Yeah, the resolution's not what I saw in the ad.
The picture was much clearer on television.
Yeah.
That's an offensive train of conversation right there. That
what
is.
Kind of ableist conversation can we have about top 10 best fakers?
Best
Who
fakers?
Else has been faking illnesses?
Been faking illnesses.
Yeah.
Oh, the Joe Buck man, the announcer
oh,
man.
Oh, Joe
yeah.
Buck. Well, yeah, what happened to Joe Buck?
The hair plug guy. Did you hear about that show?
Oh.
Okay, so no. he got hair plugs maybe like in 2008 or something, and then he said he contracted some mysterious virus, and then later like this week he came out and said that the viruses were actually from hair plugs, and he was too embarrassed to talk about them.
Then why would he talk about it now?
Like, because I have responsibility to men everywhere
with hair plugs.
Yeah, no. He lost his voice, his like vocal cords somehow. From the hair plugs. That's why he almost lost his career from it.
Is that also why he's an ass?
Yes. This might not be Joe Buck, but I'm just going to call him Joe Buck for now.
No, if it's Joe Buck, the story is good. If it's Joe Buck, if it's anyone else, it's not as good, a good story.
All right, well, Joe Buck's great. I mean, so who else?
No, he's not. Joe Buck's an asshole.
No, he's great for the list of.
Oh.
Yeah, he's on the fake list. So that's
yeah,
three.
I just know Joe Buck because he was the one who, when Randy Moss did the fake mooning to the Packers, Joe Buck was like, that is absolutely disgusting. That is a heinous act. Like, dude.
Randy Moss is the guy.
He did like a fake moon. He like pulled down imaginary trousers that
Have
don't
you heard
exist.
Randy Moss talk?
Oh, this is
something. I'm Randy Moss. I'm from Ram Ram.
West straight cash, homie. I don't give a shit. He's hilarious, dude. He should take over all the voiceover jobs that Morgan Freeman has when he dies.
Dude, Randy Moss and Jason Williams. It's
like, y'all like
chocolate.
ATM? We'll try Bank of America.
Randy Moss
no
and
fees.
White Chocolate coming out of the same small town Appalachian
DuPont,
West
baby.
Virginia high school.
Yeah, he's just throwing
time.
Him oops all day in high school. It's
disgusting.
Beautiful. Go watch his videos on YouTube right now.
Go watch videos of 40-year-old Jason Williams play pickup at the Florida Rec.
Yeah, that keeps cycling around.
Dominant.
Like,
yeah, they keep churning out the same footage.
It's the same video.
Yeah,
it's like 5 years old
or whatever.
Yeah,
no, it's not. It's like a year old, but they keep churning. They keep reposting it. It's
5 year
like
internet years.
Updated like
oh, Jason Williams video.
White yeah, it's the same one. White Chocolate amazes the crowd.
White Chocolate.
You won't believe what he does at this age.
White Chocolate.
And I've watched them all.
It's the one. It's this one.
Maybe they're different. I guess some.
No,
of them
they're all
different.
The same with different thumbnails.
No, these are different. No, well, maybe you're right. I don't know.
Y'all aren't allowed to be watching no more YouTube videos.
No, we're done.
YouTube videos on halt.
Why, man? YouTube videos are... It's culture, man. YouTube
videos are pretty much... It's an audio
format. Pretty much everything.
Yeah, well, link in description. Jason, if you don't know who Jason Williams is, I don't know what you're doing hanging around here.
Dude, everyone knows who fucking Jason Williams is.
Fucking Jason Williams, bro.
Linebacker for the Dolphins, Jason Williams.
Oh, well, there's also the Jason Williams who shot his limo driver, who was on the descent for the Nets.
Yeah, he fucked that up for all the other Williams.
This is very unfortunate. That's a very popular name.
It seems to be in athletics for one reason or another.
Yeah, fuck, man. All right, so we covered the importance or non-importance of Trump.
We touched on the heavy analysis of Trump and Hillary.
Well, no, okay, the fundamental question was, is this Trump shit just actually boring?
It's very boring.
It's not.
People's lives are just meaningless.
The thing,
not doing anything but paying attention to this man.
It's fucked up. You really do just have to rely on, as Jan Ervin would like me to reference, the Trivium method. And you like semantics really break down these things, because you see today, whatever Trump said, did he say, I thought what he was saying basically was that he was implying that I'm so powerful, you can just walk around, you can grab girls by the pussy, you know? And some people obviously took that to mean that he goes around and grabs women by the pussy regularly. So women are out here. Well, it's not just women. It's people in general are out here saying, oh, he's a rapist and he commits sexual assault.
Well, like, he does have a rape trial coming up like real soon here.
Well, him and Derek Rose are going to be in the same courtroom.
Yeah, him and
they'll be up next after each other.
Yeah, he. Yeah.
Okay.
Well,
he's potentially a rapist. No, he's potentially a rapist.
He really does take the devil's clamp and just grabs the puss, though. That's what he does.
That's lewd. That is absolutely lewd.
I was trying to be sensitive, but if we're just going to go there.
I mean, no, I think he's a rapist. I think he's probably a rapist of some sort. I think what he was saying was, I mean, you're probably right. He was just making, like...
He's making a comment on, like, how women flaunt over the fact that he is powerful, and that's, like, a...
But not actually, though. The actual context is, he's like, I gotta take Tic Tacs, because when I see, like, beautiful girls, I can't resist.
He just has to,
like,
kiss them.
Kissing them. Then he's like, and they just let me do it. So he's saying he's just doing things that they don't want him to do, but because he's, like, rich or whatever, they, like... He's like, they just, like,
yeah,
let me.
That's an interesting
so it's not even, like... It's not even like they're like into it or something. It's not even like you can say that. He really is just doing some rapey type behavior.
Very, very rapey.
Just like brushing up on women and just.
Yeah, no, it is a certain kind of crazy that's like, I have money, so you will enjoy my presence and I will be allowed to do this and you won't say shit.
Yeah, it's just a power trip.
Just, yeah, exactly. Trip. And that's what's fucked up with.
Not just, though. I shouldn't say
this
just.
This is not an anti-capitalist podcast.
Oh, it certainly is.
No, I already told you I'm an anarcho-capitalist. We're all about that over here. But or an anarcho-capitalist. What's a narco-capitalist? I want to sign up for
Dude,
that.
That's
a
bad show. Anarcho-fucking.
Yeah. Yeah.
You're not
we went through this.
On
it's been happened. But I can't even remember the point I was going to make. It's irrelevant, apparently.
It is. Yeah.
Yep.
You went down a hole and fell off.
Yep. Woo.
Goodbye.
I need a sound effect for that.
Definitely an anti-capitalist podcast.
How can we fix this system with our new
even though one third of us majored in economics, international economics, still definitely an anti-capitalist podcast and ethos.
That was my point, though. Was it with capitalism? It gives these people certain, actual power and a perception of power in which they can do whatever they want because things can be bought and sold on a market. Everything can be bought and sold. Their freedom can be bought and sold. You know, their
can love be
their
bought
morals
and sold,
can
man.
Be bought and sold. They can
you can't buy my
sell
love.
Legislation. They can you,
you
know,
have to earn my love. You can't buy it.
I don't want to lose your love.
Well, you're about so to nah. if you don't pay. Three installments of
but that's why a lot of these fucking freaky ass what was it, a documentary about the child pedophiles, A Conspiracy of Silence?
Oh yeah, Discovery Channel one.
Yeah, or was it 60 wherever it was
Discovery
it was
Channel.
Unpublished, yeah, because somebody made sure that it did not make the airways, but it was on YouTube, just about these sexual predator rings, these people just raping children.
That doesn't sound like a fun video to watch.
No, but it's real. And that's what the fuck happens.
It is.
God damn it.
Well, no new politicians are ever going to get elected because they all are going to be torrenting.
They're all going to
be uncovered by that.
I really like that theory that one's going to get elected.
This election is just setting up for that torrenting means nothing as long as you're not a rapist. So
torrenting?
Torrenting. Yes.
This is what it's all about.
This is the cyber election?
Yeah, the cyber election is coming up in 20 years. We can just reference this election back and be like, yes, I torrented 3 terabytes of HBO television, but I was
HBO
not grabbing
said
women.
I could do it.
Yeah.
HBO said I could do it. They said they were in the business of making addicts, which makes them criminals, not me. They said, steal it. And I said, okay.
But did one of you guys know someone that got a letter from, like,
don't everybody
Time
get
Warner
them.
Cable?
I've got a million of them.
From
don't do anything.
Torrenting Mr. Robot. That's
I got
a good
one.
I have not gotten
got
it.
One from Mr. Robot.
Ah. No, they don't do anything.
What's hilarious is that...
They don't even throttle your shit. Maybe they throttle
I think
shit.
They throttle, but I think that's just me getting angry.
I mean, everyone gets
throttled. They can throttle my shit all they want. Or, yeah, literally, because I'm just out here using VPNs and shit where I can just steal more than they want me to and just steal the neighbors. So, yeah, I'm out here. I don't care.
You steal from your neighbors?
I might.
That's like...
Allegedly.
Yeah, you're violating the non-aggression principle, dude.
Allegedly.
That's their private property, dude. Yeah. The internet is private property.
But what I was going to say is that these torrent sites are riddled with these links that will take... They claim that they will help you download a VPN in which you can illegally download things in a safer manner, obviously. And it's just...
Porn.
It's
no one downloads porn.
Well, no, these advertisements are just... They're fucking people who just put, like, scams in there and all sorts of fucking viruses. So they... convince you to install all these weird things and like give them access to all your passwords for the VPN so
oh,
they can
beautiful.
Help you, yeah, so they can help you torrent better.
No, we need to weed out those idiots.
Dude,
oh, we need them
hilarious.
To be downloaded.
It's so
dude.
Funny. So funny.
We need those to be downloaded on all
Who's
the
last person you know that actually got a computer virus? When's the last time you like
Oh man. I don't think I know anyone that got a computer virus.
Or like just like
my pass not my password
adware that just corrupts an entire installation.
I get emails from Twitter saying someone from Singapore is trying to access my account. Like if you want to tweet from
me,
please do it. I'm terrible.
My email gets hacked all the time.
No, those
like,
are the phishing emails. When you click the link in there to change your password,
yeah.
That's what.
Yeah.
No, these are like officially from Twitter though. Unless they know how to do that.
Have
too.
You ever dealt with scammers on eBay who send you like bullshit eBay emails?
Yeah,
those are great. And then you contact eBay and they're like, nope, that did not come through our system.
Have you guys gotten calls yet from like the IRS?
Oh, I got
saying,
dude, one fucked me up at work, dude.
Yeah, bruh. they're saying
I owe
the
money.
Police.
I'm not out here answering calls I don't know.
They said they called
Sorry.
The police on me and said they're going to be at my door if I don't wire them $1,500.
Yeah, we have a warrant for you.
Yeah, wire me money.
Yeah,
that's
go to your nearest
says.
Western and Union.
I was like, dude, you're telling me I owe a bill like that's almost the size of what I made last year? I was like, sir, I make no money. Like, I don't make money. I don't pay taxes because I don't make money.
Sorry, sir.
I get money back.
Like. I guess you haven't heard that if you make under $27,000 a year, you are not federally required to pay taxes.
Is that the number? I thought it was a lot lower
like
than
24,
that.
27.
I thought it was like 5.
No, it's way low.
Okay, good. So I didn't pay taxes last year.
Yeah, there's a local scum diddly bag who just works and he's just a fucking handyman hippie. And he was like, what do you mean taxes? Like, I haven't paid taxes since 1970. I was like, what do you mean? He's like, yeah, if you make less than this, you don't have to report taxes. And he was like, and I have two jobs, and I'm not going to report the side gig.
That man belongs in jail. That's why our roads aren't built. You see that construction in Nelsonville?
No, your roads aren't built because people are sitting around smoking cigarettes.
Dude,
working.
You literally pay taxes for like cops to beat you up and shit. It's hilarious. It's like hilarious. It's hilarious. You pay taxes to get dirty water.
Dirty water.
You pay what else? What other good Lower things water. Do you pay taxes for? Sometimes the fire department just shows up late when your house is on fire.
Did that happen to me? My house was gone.
It's not impromptu. And
my house is gone now.
You pay taxes for that.
Yeah, you definitely pay for that and just like seatbelt tickets and
you pay
speeding
for seatbelt
tickets. Six over.
Yeah, I was
like
going
that.
12 over and you get a ticket.
Mainly
just
the
police oriented things. Yeah. You pay
the
for
concept
the
of getting paid to get paying to get beaten with the Billy Club like it's an amusement park ride is really.
Do
just...
they still carry Billy
I'll
Club?
I'll do it again.
Oh, they yeah. Or wait, do they just use the flashlight now?
Do they just use the butt end of a flashlight and a gun? No Billy Club? Or they have like the cool Billy Clubs now with the handle instead of like the classic
1950s
cop.
They just put handcuffs on you and put you in the back of the car unrestrained and just like drive on like bumpy roads really fast.
They just want you to
break
your neck.
A lot.
They don't drag you behind it anymore. That's not the move. They just tie your ankles
up.
No,
that's what the actual Klansmen do. Then the police cover it up. That
seems fun. I would take the Klan ride at Universal Studios.
Well, you can just be born black. You just ride it your whole life. That's one way to go about it.
Yeah, we got to make this movie.
Yeah, this
is that
a podcast
the most
about sitting down during the national
would
anthem.
That be the most offensive movie about white people pretending to be black? A historical movie about a white man who pretends to be black during slavery and just wants to be a slave and hangs out in the, on the slave plantations.
Can well, we, there were white slaves, dude.
Well, yeah, the
go
Irish.
Talk to the
yeah,
Irish.
Yeah.
Go talk to them. They'll make sure you know.
Oh, yeah, they'll throw people, potatoes at you.
The racist people of my origin love to tell you about that. But I don't have red hair, so I really am just not out here
you
suffering
don't get
from.
To...
Yeah. Unless you hear my last name, you do not know how much of a fucking Mick I am.
I see some red hair in here.
Actually, I look like a leprechaun, so that's probably.
Yeah, yeah. I'm probably about 5'2".
Yeah. Well, that's.
Where are your shekels?
I actually collect money for being under 4'11".
Really?
We saw. Okay. Yeah. I have. If you guys want to like park close sometime, I have.
Do you have the sticker?
I have the
Is
sticker.
Is it because your legs are so short, it takes you like 20 minutes to get to the grocery store?
Dude, as soon as you said that, I was thinking about why my legs are so short. Like,
why
not
are they
something
short?
Happened. Like, my grandmother just has extremely short legs.
You're not like that guy from King of the Hill? Got his shins cut off in Vietnam?
When I was a kid, my parents used to stack books on my shoulders in concrete sacks.
Okay, that's make, why.
Yeah.
That's why.
We stunt the growth
we
of
found
my
the
legs.
Root of your stunted growth. We discovered it here. This is good.
My it's growth like, was stunted because my parents let me drink coffee when I was growing up.
My grandmother used to say that. She'd be like, if you drink coffee, it'll stunt your growth. I was like, I'm not going to drink coffee. Like, no, your genetics are what made me
I do
not
think children
tall.
Should be drinking coffee, though.
No, not at
no,
all.
I was talking
not.
To someone last night who was saying, like,
they should not
yeah, it's just like drink coffee when I was like 7. I was like, that's fucked up. And
your parents
gross.
Are fucked up liberals. That's the problem with your parents.
Yeah,
and they probably let you watch
like
porn.
Work. You shouldn't like
you
be
fuck.
Like if you're tired when you're 7, you should just be sleeping. You should
go
not be seeking chemical ways
that's
to like
you grow in bed.
Stay up longer.
Who told me you grow in bed?
You,
you
do.
Horizontal. Horizontal.
Open,
edit
dude.
His name out. I didn't say yeah. his last name, but that fucking maniac.
It's when your growth. It's when your growth plates open.
Okay.
I don't need to edit his name out, that animal's name.
Yeah. What did you? I started drinking coffee at maybe 20. Maybe I had like one or two cups a year at 20. And then I started maybe heavily drinking this year with three
19,
cups.
When I was like not doing homework at real hours. When I started just like staying up late and working.
Real homework hours, real nocturnal.
Or
hours.
Just like being out, I guess.
When I realized my anxiety was to the point of crippling, I wanted to just put cement blocks on my chest. By drinking more coffee.
No,
that's what I do. I enjoy it.
That's when you go to onnit.com and you start taking uptake inhibitors and all
okay.
sorts of other weird nootropics that are good for your brain and only emit positive energy.
Yeah,
you
need
them.
All the new bro.
I need that.
And you make sure you get a kettlebell too because that will release endorphins.
What size?
Just owning a kettlebell.
You need all the new
the
bro
expensive
brain.
Ones.
The expensive ones. I've been lifting since I was 6 years old. That's why my growth is stunted. So I don't need
yeah,
these
I've
kettlebells.
I've been drinking coffee and lifting since I was like, it's smoking cigarettes since I was like 4 years old.
Yeah, I don't need these kettlebells.
Like every like 2 years, there's like a meme like Southeast Asian child that's like smoking cigarettes and has adult mannerisms and that like goes around. Like I was just that kid.
I really just
similar to
gas.
The monkey that those Asians had trained that just walks around with like a gun and cigarettes and like takes his sunglasses off and puts them on his head.
I think we just need to start injecting our biceps with canola oil like the Brazilians.
Canola oil?
Have you guys seen that?
Hey,
no,
the
it's
canola,
not canola
oil.
It's
canola oil.
No, the shit people put to like get the fake big fuck.
Yeah, it's canola oil.
No, it's like synthol.
No,
it's
canola.
It's synthol.
It's Crisco. They
yeah,
shoot Crisco.
Really, that's what
heads.
It is. Look it up.
No, that's it's synthol, first of all. And second of all, that is a crazy level of like
oh, it's amazing.
Mental illness, dude. So it's like
oh this man's bicep
this
just
a, yeah,
exploded like
a
balloon.
This is a very visual thing, but synthol is what they put in their arms, and you see a lot of like weird rich Indian dudes walking around in sweatpants with just these exploded traps and
oh,
gigantic
yeah.
It's
arms.
It's not just Indian dudes, it's fucking like
it's,
meathead
I always
white
see videos
dudes
of Indian
Jersey.
Dudes.
I've only seen the Brazilian
okay,
article.
Yeah, like yeah.
It's, you just don't see black people doing it. That's the main thing. It's like non,
that's the main thing to
like
take away is black people
like
are not doing
synthol.
It.
They're not doing
it. Very white activity.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude. Synthol is the future of man.
I've been using canola oil and my results are great.
Large muscle mass.
Yeah.
The real question is how many people have put synthol in their penises? How many
dude,
dick implants are there?
Dude, I
nope.
You don't think so? You
nope.
don't think it's happening?
Nope.
Oh, it's nope. happening.
Nope.
Who? Name three men.
Whom?
Go okay. Google that shit right now, Nigel. Pull it up. Google it.
I'm not googling that.
That's not going on his computer.
Synthol dick implants.
You know who uses that
injections?
Computer? Nigel's mother.
The feds.
Family computer.
The
family
feds.
Computer. Belongs in the computer den. Can't be using it.
I'm not Googling synthol dick, but I'm sure there are a lot of them out there. If people, motherfuckers are making their muscles look big, you don't think they tried to make their dick look big first?
Dude, I don't give a shit what they do. Fucking Donald Trump's going to legalize that shit, and
that'll
be the end of the story.
Canola oil's already legal, though.
Donald Trump's going to subsidize synthol injections for the population, and that's that. We're going to get federally subsidized synthol, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay, one Google. This guy has a 7-pound silicone-injected penis, and you don't.
And
7 pounds?
This is gross.
How do you walk around? How do you mow the grass? How do you do daily activities?
I think you need a holster, right?
How do you take a shit?
Just plop it on the toilet seat.
It looks like a fucking bass hanging over your fucking toilet seat. It looks like a fucking fish.
It's like that elephantitis stuff, right? The guys with the big balls.
With 3 minutes too much of dick talk.
You know what's hilarious? Here's the thing, though. I'll wrap it up with this. All of the talk about this dick injection is on either bodybuilding forums or Think Steroid. So, yeah, it's just a lot of dudes who are out here totally emasculated.
Dude, it always trips me out. Like, I see this in real life. People with the bodybuilding.com. T-shirts,
yeah.
But it's like we only know that website as a place for like
Joe
4chan
Rogan
level.
Freaks.
Well, it's trolling. It's to me, it's just like 4chan level trolling. Like on the, they have like a miscellaneous board, but the people on campus are like using it for like actual bodybuilding tips, not just like semi-satirical like
bodies.
Banter.
Walking around with the
they're the ones writing
tips.
The comments, you think?
I think they're the ones that have progressed out of the 4chan level and just. Fell for the bodybuilding trap.
Okay, so the bodybuilding miscellaneous forum is one level above 4chan or one level below?
Oh, whew.
And I don't know if you're getting better. I don't know which one's better.
Yeah.
I think it's just parallel. I think it's horizontal movement.
There's you're just moving to the right or left.
this is very 4chan influenced podcast.
It's bad.
This is like the first. This is the first podcast of the 4chan generation. You got to be 24 and under.
I was listening to a podcast recently.
I arbitrarily say that because I'm 24.
With a very out of touch human being who was talking about kids, tweens. And he was like, tweens, you know, these kids who are like, he's from New York, obviously. 13, 14 years old, you know, and they're the fucking anonymous. they're the anonymous, you know. And I was like, this man is so fucking out of touch. And he's like, yeah, they're the anonymous. All these kids are wearing fucking masks and
all the
masks. They're fucking crazy, you know.
Well, it is.
They are. That is fucking crazy. These kids should not be walking around with masks on. Yeah.
It is 16-year-old racist Australians making most of your
isn't that
most
fuck?
Of the memes.
They live on the other side of the world, and they're like, yeah, you American cunts, you're going to like this about Timberlands.
And they hate black people.
Yeah, you're going to like
Australia
some Timberlands.
They're
anti-Semitic,
and they just like make jokes about Tims and Bloods in
you
New York
Tim's
and
B?
Saying B, and it's very weird.
They're,
yeah, mate,
too far
the
away.
Tims.
They don't know.
And they like
real.
Listen to like Lil Uzi Vert and Young Thug, but they're like racist, too. It's
Lil
really
Bodie, mate. Me and my mates, we was out in the fucking...
Out
in the
sticks.
Outback, you
they're
know, we drove a Subarus out there, and it was a pretty good time. And we went back to Sydney, and then we drove to Perth. It's about a 4.5-hour drive.
Then you ate your blooming onion.
And you know what else we did? We watched us a bunch of fucking movies. We watched us the fucking Jimmy? Fucking, what's his name? The HBO guy, the Australian man.
Dude, I don't know.
Christopher Lilley.
Christopher
Lilley. You're on your own with this Australian accent, dude. You're on your own.
I can't. Mine just goes default to, I don't even know what kind of accent
I'm talking about Christopher Lilley, mate. Christopher Lilley has these extraordinary HBO films. They're basically one-man shows, and he does all sorts of topics.
I think the only ethnic accent impersonation I have solidly is maybe like Nigerian accents. I'm not going to bust it out right now. It's not appropriate.
Okay.
But
that's fine. You don't have to.
As long as it stays within your, like,
I wish that was an accent,
color,
but that
I
was just our
acceptable.
Australian friend.
Yeah.
Like.
Yeah, no, that was our Australian friend. He came over.
Yeah, yeah.
He had to go, though.
Yeah. He had to go back to Perth. It's
actually, no, Australian
flight.
People are shitty. I don't fuck with Australian people at all. the one time an Australian person was in my house, mate. They used the N-word and claimed they didn't know that it was bad.
What it meant.
Which leads me to just believe Australians are just like off in that shitty island, just living in a hot pressure cooker of like racism.
It doesn't look fun.
That's extremely accurate.
I watched like, several movies filmed in Australia. Sucks. They're all terrible. Subpar movies filmed in Australia.
No, Christopher Lilley's a genius, but he may or may not be a racist.
Just kidding. I love Australians character. And what they did to the native people who lived there first.
Australia, please listen to this podcast.
Australians are also responsible for the DNC hack, so thank you, Australia.
I love their criminal... I love the fact that they're literally just the crop of like a penal colony of British criminals.
It's really, yeah, we shipped off the criminals over there.
Just criminals of the crown.
It's beautiful.
And then they just killed all the people who live there.
They broke out of jail, right?
And we're supposed to think that that's like a cool place to go vacation or something.
Yeah.
Pretty fucked up.
No, it's fucked up.
Shitty continent.
Yeah, I don't know any real Australians.
That's where that one lady's going with the backpack.
People think that there's like... They idealize these like Western countries that are not America. Like, dude, like Australia, Europe, they're all shittier than here. They're all worse.
Yeah,
like
they have real panhandlers and gypsies that steal your wallet. It's
and they just suck. And they're just
it's
like
way
poor.
Different.
No, the older we get, just like you realize America's a lot better than all these places.
Oh, the workers spending 35 hours. Oh,
yeah.
Maternity leave.
And nobody owns anything. It's great. And you pay 40% tax rates, but you just ride a bus everywhere, and the bus is paid for, and college is paid for.
I ride the bus everywhere.
Yeah. But you. You at least have this bullshit.
Yeah, you're a man of the people.
I'm a man of the people.
That's true.
True proletariat.
Yeah.
True.
The Boof Boyz are out here. We're on public transportation. We're kicking it with regular folks.
Yes, we're the real people.
The revolution will start on the bus or on the train.
It always has.
It will not start in the Uber, though.
No.
It will not start in the Uber.
Or the Lyft.
Uber doesn't pay taxes. Remember that.
Really?
Next time you get an Uber, remember they do not pay taxes.
I leave all doors open when I exit an Uber.
That's rude. You shouldn't be rude to the drivers. You should be rude to the company.
No.
Find a manner.
That's how you stop them you can do from that. Driving for Uber, though.
Why would they stop driving for Uber? I guess if they're bad.
That's how you start.
All these people leaving the door open. Yep. It's not worth it.
Not worth it.
The amount of times I got to lean back and shut this door.
No, they have to get out of the car. You can't just like lean back. I sit on the opposite side back seat, so they have to get out of the car.
I want to get back to this, though. We need to really just hound how much people who... fantasize about Europe and really just put it on a pedestal need to come down and need to understand that they were just sent to Europe in controlled environments where they were just with guides or with like a family of people who were affluent and could afford to not be with poor people.
I think it's the same way the other side too. Europeans are like, oh, we want to go to America. I think that people just want to go to a different place.
Yeah, they go to Disneyland. And they're like, America's great.
No, they literally travel across all of America. They go to like New York, Philadelphia. Bismarck,
who does this?
The good places.
Dude, you've never been to one of these major tourist destinations and seen these people in like cropped pants and fucking white five panels?
Oh, no.
Holy shit.
White pants are gross as shit.
Yeah.
Unless you're
and
in
Europeans
Miami
like
doing
them a
coke.
Lot. And if logic tells us A plus B equals Europeans suck, that's what the logic.
I put that on my math test and I got a B minus.
Did you assault the teacher?
No. I don't do that.
I definitely would have challenged that play.
Yeah?
Challenged the call on the field.
But yeah, no, man. Like, I don't know. America kind of sucks. Kind of sucks a lot, but, like, I don't know. I'm
it
just,
sucks
like, reactionarily.
Less
than I'm just reactionarily pro-American to, like, spite my classmates, I suppose.
You just alienate yourself from everyone, correct?
Yeah. I've just been like, it's not that bad, guys.
Yeah.
It's really not that bad.
Yeah, that's the general idea. If you learn anything, learn that.
But it is that bad. We're just saying Europe's worse. That's all we're saying.
Yeah, yeah. There are many worse places, and y'all need to like realize that. It really is one of those things. It's like, are things really that bad right now, or do we just have more access to information than we've ever had? Or, like, were they not just beating the shit out of people with billy clubs like it was a sport
think
the 70s and 80s?
It's pretty bad.
I don't necessarily have a correct appraisal of, like, how bad it is, but I think people are just, like, too blasé. They're just too, like, neutral about everything. And, like...
Oh, I think on a larger scale, yeah. But
I've been reading a lot
about instances in particular.
What do you mean?
No, I think that you're correct that people, a lot of people have a see no evil, hear no evil, speak no evil, as far as it applies to police brutality and racism. They just don't want to look at it.
I'm not even talking about that. I'm just talking the general atmosphere thing. People just aren't angry enough. People aren't like, and it's not wokeness. It's not about wokeness, but just like people are too like anesthetized by shit like prestige television. They're not like angry. People aren't like up.
Oh no,
man.
They're too
be, like, up.
Yeah, people are subdued by their cell phones and other things they have to distract themselves all day. They don't have to look at reality. You don't even have to consider what's going on in life as long as it's not in your fucking backyard or at your cubicle or on your drive to work every day. You don't face it. Doesn't
exist. Yeah, no. I just been reading fucking. Man, I just read. Just spent like a week reading about like radical like. White working class activists in the 60s and 70s. Just like everyone was up and mad at the cops, and it was all this whole like us versus the pigs, like ethos.
Well, now
you
we
had the Vietnam War. Yeah. The Vietnam War was definitely responsible for a lot of that. But
you
like,
think that's cyclical?
Perhaps, but like, yeah, there just hasn't been. You need something like that.
We have
the media
war
now
and
of social media.
The Iraq War discouraged people, and then after the Iraq War, we saw an increase in. Police brutality. We saw what a lot of people perceive.
But
to
like,
be
what was the Iraq? Where was the real anti-war movement for Iraq? Like the real successful one that was like across.
Oh, there wasn't.
Lines.
But I think
it wasn't fucking.
It's one
long.
Of those things that if you poll people now, it's like 90% of people are like, "Yeah, it was a bad idea."
Sure, but that doesn't fucking mean we all know who was like.
No, but I'm
the
saying
war
that
when it happened.
That that mentality. I'm not saying at the time, but I'm saying now it wears thin on people, and that's why you have a lot of animosity now. And people don't trust the government. They're like, you fucked us over oil in 2004. Like, that's why I don't believe anything you have to say. You know, that's like a good basis
oh, yeah.
for people to start on.
That's I believe that. Same thing that happened in Colombia with the FARC. They don't believe that now. They don't
yeah.
want those
don't
people.
Believe.
It's just like
they
things happen.
Yeah.
Like 9/11.
They just don't believe.
Things like this. Fucking the war.
They don't
war.
Believe anything's going to change. So why even vote?
Exactly. And
yeah, no, Colombia's a good. Yeah, it's a good example of people just.
Yeah.
Like, and yeah, I don't know. You can try to frame it like. Like people, I've seen people try to frame it like it's a Brexit thing where it's like the old people
closing the walls, basically.
And like the young people didn't come out and vote because the young people wanted peace, but the old people just came out in numbers and voted for no peace with FARC. But like, I don't think that's a good analysis because you know we have a friend who like lives down there and it's disillusionment. You know, he was saying a few months ago that people are upset because the government was paying the FARC to stay in Cuba.
Mm-hmm.
That's tax dollars going to FARC again, and they're just tired of it. And then when the times in the past when the FARC has signed peace deals, they grow cocaine in like the sanctuary lands they get and stuff. So yeah, people just don't like trust.
They just
them.
Don't trust them. Yeah,
they don't trust. They don't trust like that.
At the same time, they really just wanted them all in prison. That's what it sounded like from the old people that voted, though. So it was like
yeah,
what 37% because
people have died.
Turnout?
People have
yeah.
died, and the
yeah.
truth and reconciliation shit only goes so far. And people want you know to see the people who hurt them get hurt back. So what do?
Close your walls.
It's just the way
all
of the world.
I
want to
be is El Chapo. But yeah, you can't. I don't know. That. Oh yeah, I've been trying to get. I haven't been able to find it, but I've been trying to get like racial voting numbers on the Brexit because again, they try to like frame it like it's old people versus young people. All the stupid old people voted to leave, but like I've heard that like Sikhs and like Nigerians and shit voted to leave.
Which no, yeah, like the
like,
smartest people there voted to leave.
Right, right.
Reason.
So yeah, you can't necessarily. Yeah, I tend to reject these like it's old people versus young people narratives. I don't
yeah.
think that's
racial
shrimmered.
I had to get that in. Sorry, I had to throw that.
Well,
I think you're right though about the Brexit, and it's interesting to pull yourself back and look at it now after it's been what a month or so. And after all this, you know, racism, blah, 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 screamed about the Brexit. And yeah, like you said, see who actually voted for it. And you're like, oh, there were some.
Well, it is, I'm sure a lot of it's racism, but I'm also just saying it's a lot of young, mad, racist people, too. It's not,
yeah.
Oh,
yeah, yeah.
It's not
yeah,
just
yeah.
old people that are racist or whatever.
Racism's not dead.
There, yeah. Even a blind squirrel finds a nut every now and then. It's not like these people are. Cranking out intelligent decisions every
oh,
day.
Yeah.
It's like they just happen to align with the more intelligent people on that decision. We done it.
I think
do you gotta go now?
No.
Okay, you're still here? Well, I guess we're going to leave.
You're leaving me?
Yeah. We hit an hour.
We did hit an hour. It's been about an hour. It's been great. I'm glad though.
What were we just talking about?
We're talking about Brexit.
SSX Tricky.
SSX Tricky and the Brexit and how they relate.
Yeah. That's our new band. SSX Tricky and the Brexits.
Oh, okay. This is a good topic, and then we can keep talking or finish after this. Who gives a fuck? But Alex Jones is paying $5,000 to anybody who I don't know.
Dude, I will take him up. Key.
What do you think that starts with? Alex Jones is paying somebody.
This is pre. This is pre Donald Trump's deal coming.
Okay,
out.
Okay.
But he was paying people to go to like Clinton rallies and yell about Bill Clinton being a rapist, and he was just paying.
Ladies and gentlemen, $5,000 to anyone willing. I taking him up?
I will. I'll go.
He had so many people that were like.
Alex,
Bill Clinton's a racist. Infowars.com. Oh my god, that's amazing.
Yeah, so he was like, "Ladies and gentlemen, I'm writing $25,000 worth of checks right now, just from the people who've recorded. You can make this. Everybody's got to be a patriot. I've been locked away in Phoenix. I've been locked away many times before. I've been taken away from my family.
Ladies and gentlemen, I went to the Bohemian Grove.
They're pigs, ladies and gentlemen." But yeah, he'll pay you $5,000. All you got to do is scream about Bill Clinton being a rapist.
Yeah, that's funny. How did all these anti-pig libertarians all of a sudden become cop bootlickers when they started killing black people? That is the most disappointing. That is one of the most disappointing things. Because I used to be like, okay, at least we're all in this anti-fucking authoritarian like police thing
it's
together.
It's just bipartisan.
As soon as these black people started getting killed, like, well, maybe the black people were uppity and we need law and order and we got to empower the police. Like, what happened to your fucking principles? They have none. Libertarians have none. No principles.
I also think, yeah, they certainly have no principles. I agree with that. But it's also political alignment is just like they have to fucking be against all these things. It's like, well, Hillary's taking our guns and she wants immigrants, so now we're racist gun toters. Like, it's just you have to be the antithesis of what you're fighting. You just have to align in certain ways.
But we like guns.
Oh, I love guns.
We're pro-gun as shit.
Love guns.
Yeah, I'm pro weapons. I think you should have a mace.
I didn't
a ball
update
and chain.
My phone, so I wanted to keep the gun emoji.
We discussed that yesterday. Real motherfuckers do not update
real
their phones.
Gun emoji.
I don't like water guns. They piss me off.
Yeah, those don't kill people.
Yeah, I'm still on iOS like 6.
Yeah, good. It's good for you.
But yeah, no, I don't respect gun nabbing city liberals who want to like legislate guns to people who live in rural areas, because it's a wedge issue that doesn't get you anywhere and doesn't do anything, and it just alienates people who should be voting.
There's a great ad promoted by the NRA on TV now. It's about some fat lady that got attacked with an 8-inch blade in a parking lot, and she said she had a gun and protected herself, and Hillary's trying to take the guns, so vote for Trump.
So I'm scared to go grocery shopping now.
I just love that she had the inch of the knife, an 8-inch blade.
Oh,
it was beautiful.
What kind of gun did she have?
She didn't say in the
ad.
She
had like a big hunting rifle that she got out of the car and assembled and like
her musket. She had to pack it.
She saw him lunging and she just packed it in time.
She saw a man. She just saw a man walking.
She was towing around a revolutionary cannon.
Yeah.
And just like happened to be loaded and she like lit the match and lit the wick.
I was actually there. She had me assist with the cannon. You need three people to man the cannon.
I was noticing Ted Strickland's like motto or his, you know,
dude,
his
Ted Strickland's based. It's fucked up. He's gonna lose.
He's not gonna lose.
I'm gonna tell you what's fucked up and why I can't support Ted Strickland. I found this out today on my way in to the studio. I found it on the stoop. And I opened it up and I was like, oh, Ted Strickland. You know, people have been bashing him. Let's see what Ted Strickland's about. And his first line is, I'm Ted Strickland. You know, I care about working people because that's who I am and that's who I care about. Like this long fucking spiel. And I was like, that sounds familiar to me. I think I've heard that before. And sure as shit, I look it up and Dan Aykroyd's character in Tommy Boy literally has the same exact line about selling brake pads
it's
to
neuro-linguistic programming.
About
dude.
Selling car parts. He's like, yeah. That's I sell parts
Tommy Boy
for the
vote.
Working man because that's who I am and that's who I care
gonna
about.
Gonna get that subliminal Tommy Boy vote.
They found the character in pop media that
I was like,
everyone relates to the most, and they went towards that.
It's in the back of people's brains. Most people won't even activate as much as it did for you, and it'll just be like there, and they'll think they're voting for Dan Aykroyd when they go, and everyone loves Dan Aykroyd.
Dan Aykroyd is about
that might be that might be the next Boof viewing session. Dan Aykroyd UFO documentary.
Yeah, no, we need to.
Dan Aykroyd is a non-ironic alien. Oh my, look at his hands.
Oh, those are good hands.
Look at that hand.
No, he did. He did a particular one in the 90s. I can't remember what it was called, but it was look like a big fox, like Dateline NBC or something.
Just YouTube Dan Aykroyd UFO and look at the pensive facial expressions and hand motions. He's so concerned about the alien
thing. You really just need to watch the thumbnails. You don't even need to watch them. Peruse the thumbnails.
Also, Hillary's campaign manager.
No, you're missing the best one. That Dan Aykroyd was on Sway.
He was on Sway in the morning.
Oh wow!
What did he do? Did he kick a free? Three years ago, Dan Aykroyd kicked a free.
Dan Aykroyd tells the stories behind his four UFO sightings on Sway in the morning. That's your homework. That's your viewing.
Homework of the week. Report back.
All right, but on the topic of UFOs, Hillary's campaign manager. John Podesta wants to declassify the UFO files, and I don't understand what kind of
I'm looking for the answers.
I don't understand what kind of nerd conspiracy theory vote they're trying to get with this like Huffington Post article, but like it's very odd.
I just finished X-Files and I'm very into this.
I need the X-Files vote.
According to Alex Jones, they won't release the files because it has to do with the fact that there are literal demons on Earth. Oh, and then it's a battle between good and evil and has nothing to do with aliens.
This is a cosmic battle.
Do you guys remember that
larger
video?
Than you and me.
This beer. This demon, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh.
Oh, no, yeah, news site, HuffPost just posted.
No, I didn't mean to play that intentionally.
But no, do you remember that video of, like, from the depths of hell? It's like some gargled audio of the devil saying something. Oh, I remember
Led Zeppelin backwards.
Yeah. Just
dude, those E-Bombs World videos were scary as shit, dude. No, it wasn't
a whole
just
website.
It was the subliminal messaging E-Bombs one that, oh man, dude, that stuff was spooky. But I think some of them actually had screamers embedded in them, so they'd be like scary as shit for like 4.5 minutes. Then there'd be a screamer at the end.
Oh yeah, the one just like the popping up snake, the long snake with the face. Oh yeah, I remember these. We'd watch these in the library in elementary school.
What was the other one? What was the Ohio Players album with the woman like dumping honey on herself?
Yeah.
And they're like, her skin got stuck to the album during the photo shoot, and her like career as a model was ruined. And that's why on the Ohio Players song, you can hear a woman screaming,
"Roller Coaster of Love."
Yeah.
And she's dying.
Those were her screams.
No. That's two different stories. Okay. See, you heard that story, but I heard that. That was the dude's girlfriend, and he murdered her.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, in, like, the background, he murdered her in the studio. That's the story I heard. So that's so funny how, like, these legends get started. And
Dude. Yeah, that shit was spooky than a...
The motherfucker.
Like, ghost sightings, which clearly just camera artifacts, but it's still, like...
Yeah, like, here's somebody's brother walking in the... That's the same thing with these goddamn clown videos.
No, the clowns aren't real. There's no clowns. No one's actually dressing up, right?
No. Well, it's probably happening, but it's not real. Like, the numbers are not real.
It's snowballed into a real effect,
fear
though.
Is not real.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. I think that the propaganda spawned like 8 people to go
go to Halloween USA and buy a knocked up.
I think at this point the police probably have a list. They're like, they go to Halloween USA and they're like, anybody who buys a clown outfit, ask for their ID.
Yeah, you need to show an ID to buy a clown costume now.
Yeah, figure out how we can track them.
Yeah,
that'd be a good episode of Cops. Clowns. Like a good interaction. Just
clowns.
Like
no, I want themed cops where they just look for a certain type
clown
of
clown interactions.
There's a certain crime. Like certain tonight crime. We're just doing a certain. It's kind of like a purge in reverse. Like tonight we are only arresting people for
out taillights, and then they find some other cool things.
Cops is fairly diverse, honestly, as far as a television show. Because they do a lot in like Florida, where they're just like dumb white people, and then they also I don't think they just do Florida. I think
they do Campus PD. That was a good one too.
Yeah, because they're not going to like Dade County. Wait,
there's a Campus PD.
Campus PD. Yeah,
what kind of crimes are on those? Is it they just did rape and DUIs and marijuana?
I only watched it because they were at UC for a long time.
Yeah, like caught somebody smoking weed behind a dumpster.
No, there's just drunk kids getting in fights and getting robbed, and it's pretty funny. You'll just see them try to explain their
like
story.
Like bad
to
fighting, no technique. They don't really like know how to hurt each other.
Yeah.
Bad fist swinging.
We all know how to fight at Boof Boyz.
Yeah, all the Boof Boyz know how to fight. I'm well versed in the fight.
Yeah.
No, we just don't fight. If you don't know how to fight, you just don't fight. But if you don't know how to fight and you're just out here fighting and doing it poorly,
I'll fight you right now.
Yeah.
We'll have
a giant fight.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've been studying
jiu-jitsu.
Akimbo? Is
Joe
that a
Rogan
thing?
Jiu-jitsu.
Kimbo Mutombo?
Who's that dude on MSNBC? The dude on MSNBC logged me. He's like, he has been teaching himself judo in prison, and Steven Seagal is his hero.
Oh, God. You were telling me about that. I don't remember who
Steven
it was.
Seagal looks good now. You see him?
I think Steven Seagal has some weird, like,
no,
conspiratorial
he's broken.
Beliefs
yeah.
as well.
Steven Flying Seagulls.
Yeah, who are some other like good like famous people into conspiracy theories? Prince was into chemtrails.
Of course he was.
He gave that really weird, vague interview. He's like, and someone told me that there were things in the sky, and I did some reading, and they're spraying us. And people are like, Prince believes in it, so I believe in it.
I don't know anyone else.
Why not? What?
And that man overdosed on opiates, so that's what you get.
That's what you get.
That's what you get for having heroes, people.
How old was he? Did he fall in the 27 trap?
Yeah.
Oh,
Prince
okay.
was 27 times two.
Yeah, Prince was 27.
Pete Carroll's a 9/11 truther.
Jimmy Graham.
Pete Carroll has questions about Tower 7.
Oh, yeah,
he
no, he's a
fell.
Truther.
He doesn't know why it fell. He just wants to know. He just wants answers. Is
he's
that
a
so
truther
wrong?
And apparently a man who... What the fuck? I'm sorry. He's a truther,
be.
But he's also a man who throws the ball in the 1 yard line.
That's the
that
conspiracy
was a
10-minute
too. Joke, I'm sorry.
It's okay.
That's conspiracy too.
Lord, give me a sign.
5 out of 8.
5 out of 8.
Yeah, that was,
that's better. Yeah. Could have been worse.
Could have been. What are we looking at? All right.
We got to piss. What is your fucking issue?
I'm hungry.
You don't like all the snacks we have here in the Shiloh Boof Studio?
They're pretty good, but.
Dude, so,
I'm
like, Avalanche
to.
Athens Pizza is supposed to be, like, the best pizza in the world. How asinine is it to be, like, we've
sampled Do they say they're
the
best
pizza
in the world?
Yeah, they, like, won some, like, stupid, like, best pizza in America. Like, some stupid, like,
Who's voting in that?
Cuck.
Who's voting in best
who's
pizza?
Who's entering it? What, cuck. Like... Yeah, it's a cuck activity.
No, it's the guy on YouTube in the suit with the slick back hair. He voted Avalanche Pizza.
He's literally...
What's his name? He voted for Avalanche.
Not the dude who degreases pizza.
No,
the other
no,
guy.
Not that man.
The
this
guy
is,
who reviews
he,
bad
he
food.
Reviews Monster Energy drinks.
Yeah, and like Burger King.
Is America the
fries.
Only country where
yeah.
things like fall off the pizza? If you like, isn't that good, healthy?
It's the
European
report of the
pizza
week.
Doesn't like
drip,
don't like drip and slide off of it.
This man is
you
eating
can't power
Papa John's
a car with European
car.
Grease.
Report of the week.
Report of the week. Yeah, very
yeah,
respectful.
We're big fans of Report of the Week here.
If you're listening,
big fans.
We love you.
Yeah, it's like what. This bubble of people like making real money off like YouTube reaction videos off like just like eating food and being gluttonous on the internet that has
this
to,
is
like,
taking a while
soon.
To make this video right. Look at this, just like little things going on in the background.
Earhum was telling us that on Twitch, on Twitch people are like viewing into social eating.
Oh
it's
yeah,
a very
yeah, yeah.
big thing.
Oh.
That people are like watching other people eat.
Why and, would you do this?
No, he was like, I assumed it was like, yeah, people want to eat with other people. They want to be in a group.
Right.
And no. People are just like fucked up and don't want to spend money and want to watch other people eat nice food. And they're like,
Are they eating while.
No, they're eating. They're eating bland soy.
Yeah, yeah.
They're eating bland soy that has no flavor.
Oh my God.
So they're getting like.
They're
getting the
food
calories,
powder.
But they're getting the enjoyment of like seeing like.
This sounds
food.
Like a good social group. How do I get in? Can you guys introduce me? Do you guys have leverage into this world? I kind of want
this
in.
This online community?
Yeah, I kind of want
sorry,
in.
Are we going undercover?
Yeah, let's go undercover.
Hardcore investigative internet journalism.
We can do it. That's crazy. So I'll watch you
eat. Is it like a fetish thing?
I'll watch you eat.
Are they like masturbating while they like watch the person eat, or is it really?
No,
just
they're
like...
just watching it. He said that it was really popular in Asia, and it must have gotten so popular that American markets had to pick it up.
I'm going
and
to become
like we may as well cash out on these people watching people eat.
I'm going to become really popular in Ireland and just start getting drunk at bars and live streaming myself.
That's
for
a good
other
idea.
People, other what? People to watch my progression.
They'll just call you a pussy. They'll be like, he doesn't drink enough.
I'm going to live stream like my sad alcoholism.
Yeah.
Just like people watch and donate.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
My Patreon is more gas station
like and subscribe.
Vodka.
Will rich and successful people like pay to watch me be a schlup if like a detriment on society? I wonder what it'd be like to be shitty.
That's like the purge. That's like a real
no. There's
life
a movie like that
that could be ethical. They just like pay like gross people to just like be even grosser, and they subsidize it. You're like, you're not allowed to do anything healthy. You're not allowed
put these
to,
body
like...
cameras on you, and people are gonna pay to look at it.
There's a movie like that. Who's the guy from Brule's Rules? What's his name?
What? A who?
John C. Reilly?
Yeah, John C. Reilly. He's in a movie where he's in a bad time. He stumbles upon this guy with a lot of money and wants to watch him do just terrible things to himself. He makes him cut off his pinky for like $20,000. Oh, it's a crazy movie. It just like progresses into that, and then eventually he just wants him to kill someone. What's for like $100,000?
Is it a comedy? That doesn't sound
no, it's
funny.
Not a comedy.
It's very serious.
I think
C.
so.
Reilly and
you think
yeah.
so?
Serious.
I didn't know what to take from. I was laughing.
He was in Gangs in New York.
That was a comedy.
That's a
that
shitty
was not
movie.
A serious
that movie
film.
Sucks.
I never.
Dude.
Is that the one with Leo?
We watched it in like history on film. What a bogus class.
I never
school.
Saw that
yeah.
one.
Mm-hmm. The bogus. Soundtrack was just the Dropkick Murphys. That stupid sailing off to Boston song over and over.
What that ruined like 40% of bars. Thank you, movie.
Yeah.
Like Riverdance music?
Yeah. Literally. We're sailing off to Boston. We're
yeah, what's up with Riverdance? That's some fucked up stuff there.
Hey, that's my ethnicity. Those are my people. Do not.
It's not okay.
Don't be tripping off our Riverdance.
Yeah, how do you do that? I would like a demonstration.
My grandmother tried to talk to me about getting into that as like a cultural thing to do and appreciate.
You just wear wooden
like,
shoes, or is that
yeah,
Holland?
Yeah, no, that's Clogs. Holland. But they do have special shoes. Irish gross. People are into like fucked up tap dancing and shit.
Oh yeah, no, and they wear the weird
it's
wigs.
Like a mountain people.
Yeah, yeah,
shit.
They wear like the curly wigs.
The fucking Wild and Wonderful Whites. That yeah. What's his name?
JJ.
No, not JJ. But yeah, something with a J. One of the Whites. That's what
J.J. Watt.
His claim to fame was. Yeah, J.J. Watt, his claim to fame is being a redneck on Social Security who sells pills.
I want to be on Social Security.
I just want to go to, like, poor communities and make documentaries about them, then leave and just, like, make money off the documentary.
Yeah, let's just go. Let's go exploit that community.
But then I'll go around and say I did things like spread awareness. Then I can go around and like make myself
isn't that
feel
what liberals
good about
do?
The transaction.
Isn't that what liberals do? They pay you in awareness.
That's
they
the
take
whole
all
concept.
The money and you get
I'm
awareness.
Into that.
Hey, we have this foundation that raises awareness. Now I just take the money and I spend
you're
it.
Gonna raise
I
awareness
just built
and
a well in
dialogue.
Uganda for a village.
I built a single well. For
read my blog and experiences while I was there.
If you've been to Uganda on a mission trip, come fight me.
You ready to fight?
Real talk.
7 under my belt to Uganda. 7 wells built.
No, I just sleep so well at night knowing that my micro loan really made a difference.
Yes.
Really made a difference. Really brought a lot of capital to the region.
High interest rates just
really
ruining your body.
Material conditions.
I'm into it.
There's some fucked up shit going on.
What's going on?
Heroin in the French ghetto.
You'd rather not disclose?
Yeah, it's
on the booth.
Up. Yeah, it's fucked.
That's okay.
What, the plan
we're here
through?
For you.
Yeah, the plan did not go through.
Plan did not.
Plan C. We're on plan
episode.
C now. We're on
I
plan
might be
C.
going to prison.
Plan A and B did not
yeah,
work.
We got to go on the run now.
Yeah, so we might have to leave.
We could do a podcast like John McAfee did, where he was just like...
international criminal.
Yeah, he was just an international criminal in Brazil running around taking phone calls.
He was doing a lot of
phones.
ICE.
Yeah,
of ice.
Making
ice,
not
ice
just
and
doing it,
ice.
But he was so self-sufficient with his addiction, he was just making ice. He was like, I'll just make like 30 pounds, and I won't have to make ice for like a couple months.
What's your top five favorite drug names? I'm going to go ice.
All right, before we
ice,
do that,
ice.
I was reading this article about a guy who was a lawyer, and he somehow got into doing meth and was like in so heavy that he finally ended up getting into like dealing meth and just... paying this man to make meth. Oh my God. And he got busted, and he just had gallons of meth in his basement. Just gallons.
They measure that in gallons?
Well, that's what they store it in, is like 5 gallon buckets.
It was in drums.
Yeah, he literally had stacks of 5 gallon fucking buckets.
From the warehouse.
And they were like, what the fuck? And some of it had gone bad, apparently.
No, remember when we were on Tumblr, like 2010, 2011, like...
The meth
Remember getting to like heroin Tumblr and meth Tumblr, and these people who were just logging their like functional meth addiction that slowly would just degenerate
meth
into like
hot
dropping
in, like,
out of school. Yeah, it was like weird, like goth. There were like your goth kids who like were doing it for fun. There were a lot of like heroin.
They wanted
kids
experiences,
like that. But some of them were just like very weird and like creepy blogs of just like a normal college student who's just like abusing meth to like try to live their life, and you could just see it not going well. Yeah. Like I can't pay my bills, like it's too much school, too much work, I'm just gonna start smoking a little meth here and there, and then it just dovetails into something. Like,
there were a lot of documentaries too about like guys were like, I ran a law firm and I would just do 70 hours of work straight and then I would sleep for 3 days, and you're like, Jesus,
it worked for
Christ.
A couple years, but just caught up with me, you know.
I know people have worked like 80 hour weeks.
It's gross.
It's crazy.
I'm trying to live like
that. I don't know how you do it. Where's the time?
What are they actually working on? Something
I really don't just like
worth that.
They say finance. Financial
like practicing,
modeling.
Yeah, that's not
bullshit.
Worth it.
What does that mean?
If you're like practicing law with that amount of time, it's not like worth it. Unless you're like creating tangible products. Like,
yeah, no, I have a dirt like slate.
They're just monitoring
the market. I'm here to tell you it's trash. Do not get taken advantage of and work 80 hours a week in dirt slave.
I moved rocks and
literally,
and
I might as well been in prison.
I tilled my rose.
I just bashed rocks to make gravel with a ball and chain on my ankle and an orange jumpsuit.
Well, is this fascist propaganda done?
Yeah, I gotta piss. Are we gonna take a break or are we just gonna be over?
I don't know, man. You're fine next to it. Yeah.
All this pissed off, I ain't get dumb. Poppin' niggas all like Crisco. I smoking all the gas like sicko. Fat ass all I bitched off. Big rounds all my whips off. Dirty clips all my clicked off. It's all up, joy, don't shit dumb. We let off shots, see you about to get hit off. Outside, I pop out. Old block, bring them glocks out. 300, bring them chops out. We shoot all your block now. Fredo, bring them blocks out. Receipt, bring them crates out. I wanna bring them racks out. Make your bitch wanna stay out. But don't think she gon' get paid out. I just like to play around. With niggas, I don't play around. My boy shoot up the playground. So please don't get sprayed out. Sirens on the way now. We can do this all day now. Shoot you what you say now. I know she wanna come up. I got lots of commas, Snoopy and Ferragamo. That's why I am so stuck up. How I'm first, I'm fucked up. Bayro got me puffed up. She got a fast, and you know that I don't fuck up. All these bitches know I ain't get dumb. Poppin' niggas all like Crisco. I'm smokin' on the gas like Sicko. Fat ass all I bitch dumb. Big rounds all I will score. Dirty clips on my click dog. It's all up, joy, don't shit dog. We let off shots, see you about to get hit dog. They say no all the mobs, spazzing out in the potty. GV in the squad, she sucks, we don't need nobody. And these bitches call me pop, cause I got lots of money. It's a whole block parade, dropping enemies behind. Better love your woman, so some fuck anyone. These commas steady coming, I turn nothing into sun. I be satisfied when my deal won't sleep for none. And we love getting money, I swear we won't sleep for none. See how we pull our glass out, hollow tails pop out. Dirty clubs stick out. Hopefully don't get shot down on the floor. I'll flood your block out. Disrespect my block now, guarantee you get shot down. Chop and shot your block down. All this bitches know I ain't get dumb. Poppin' niggas all like Crisco. I'm smokin' all the gas
Dirty clip, store my clip, don't. It's all up, joy, don't shit, don't. We let our shots